విద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశ ఋషుభ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః సర్వోప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన గణ ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుహే నమః. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ అండ్ విత్ లక్ష్మీ కటాక్షం టు యూ అండ్ యువర్ ఎంటైర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ టుడేస్ భగవద్గీత వర్స్ నంబర్ 31 ఆఫ్ సెకండ్ చాప్టర్. శ్రీ భగవాన్ వాచ స్వధర్మమపి చావేక్ష్య న వికంపితుమర్హసి ధర్మ్యాధ్యయుద్ధాశ్రేయోన్యత్ క్షత్రియస్య న విద్యతే. భగవాన్ కృష్ణ ఆఫ్టర్ ఫినిషింగ్ అ హ్యూజ్ టాపిక్ కాల్డ్ ఆత్మవిద్య, నౌ హీ వాంట్స్ టు బిగిన్ వన్ మోర్ సీక్రెట్. దట్ సీక్రెట్ విచ్ ఇస్ బ్యాక్డ్ విత్ సో మెనీ నాలెడ్జ్ అబౌట్ లైఫ్. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్, I'll give a small example. If a person goes and sits in the bus, conductor comes in order to give the tickets. He asks, "Where do you want to go, sir?" He says that, "I don't know." You think about the situation. You know where it is, but if a person says, "I don't know," we feel strange. It's like he is joking. That's what happens in our life. When we were born, we were not aware what to be done. Our parents helped us what the language, and they helped us to pronounce ma, papa, everything. This father's name, mother's name, and every detail about our own thing, we have to be taught how to brush our mouth, and we have to be taught how to take bath, and we have to be taught how to have food. No animals has these trainings. They have their own trainings. A calf, after being born, immediately it walks, but we took few months, maybe more than 2 years. We take long process for everything. Life prepares us slowly, firmly, for what? To reach a great destination. But that destination is not taught properly to the human being. No cows has bank balance, but in the name of cow, nowadays there is a bank balance, that's a wonderful. But no birds has got hospitals, and now, you know, the pet animals are treated. Pet animals, if we give them freedom, they will be healthy. Now, to get completeness, a flower doesn't depend on any other source than the nature. The life is endowed with nature. A flower never fails to get completeness. A tree never fails to get completeness. The all animals, creatures under the sea or in the sky, under the earth, on the earth, they have their own normal life to get completeness. Completeness means a growth and reaching the destination and dying without dissatisfaction. So that dissatisfaction happens only to the human being. We need to insurance our life because we think far. Okay? So if you are worryless person about future, means you should not put insurance even to your car. We think about future, just accept. But when Shastra says about your future, you are, you know, acting like a deaf and dumb. We are, not you. I'm not blaming. That is the situation. When Shastra says you have to select your duty, we don't care about it. But we are confused. After completion of 10th or plus 2, go and ask that student, what do you want to pursue in future? You can see the confusion, ocean of the confusions. He is very confused. He will think that I would like to go for arts college or somewhere, to MCA or BBA, life. If you ask a little bit more question, do you know about completely that field? He will say that. No, I'm not, but I'm thinking, keep on thinking. But my teacher said that, my chacha said that, my uncle said that, my father also feels it. My mother says, you know, beta, whatever you want to select, you select, but select properly what is suitable to you. Are you having that ability to select? No, after even studying 15 years, it's very sadful. People are left with confusion. Why? Because there are so many choices. Now, where there are choices, you need to have the selecting capacity. You need to know how to select it. In order to select it, you need to know the ability which are known as a free will. The ability to select properly, you should know how to use your free will. What is free will means? Free will means kartum va akartum va anyata va kartum shakyam. And Swamiji, why are we bringing this topic? Because we have to be Arjuna now. Yes, we are being with Arjuna alone. But the Krishna brings that, Arjuna, according to your dharma, your swadharma. Swadharma means your individual duty. Every individual have their own duty. That duty, it has got its own norms fixed by our scriptures. Knowingly, unknowingly, we are aware about our scriptures. But the thing is, we have to accept or not. That's the question. If you accept, you will be confusionless. I don't say that you will be free from confusion. But if you completely follow the Shastra, no confusion at all. But we are not taught. We are not given priority on the Shastras. We are given priority something, you know, the rules and regulations. And people are not aware about the constitution of a nation. I'm not against with any educational system, but the educational system should help to give the clarity about himself and about the destination which to be reached. We are the people, we think for the future. We are the people we plan for and we deposit money for our family members. Even after me, my family should not suffer. That much matured and people are endowed with the sacrificing attitude. That is to be understood. Now, he says, you are a Kshatriya. Kshatriya means what? Kshatriya is the word to define a person. Arjuna, the name of Arjuna is Arjuna. It's not an adjective of a name. It's a kind of noun which clarifies Arjuna, what kind of duty that he is endowed with, and by following those duty where he is going to reach. Now, who is Kshatriya? Kshatriya is the person who protects people and dharma. And Kshatriya is the person one should protect dharma and one should fight against adharma. Now, Kshatriya has the duty means all other categories. Yes, there are four categories. divided, categorized by our Shastra. Why? What is the purpose? And this Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Sudras, you know all these four words, but you don't know completely what they are meant for. I can damn sure that you are not completely understanding the meaning of the Shastra. If you want to know the meaning of these four words, you have to dig Shastra, because those words are given in the Shastra itself. Therefore, what? You should not get meaning from somebody else. He may be mistaken because he may give misinterpretation. That misinterpretation is happening everywhere. These words are not to confuse you. What I mean, these words are given to a person to get clarity about himself and what to be done the duty. Every creature has its own duty. A human being, we have taken responsibility because of being superiority, nature. Because we think we are endowed with sixth sense, therefore we worry about, we think about other creatures. Even we want to protect tiger, all the animals, that jungle animals. We want to protect them. We want to protect tiger, lion, even snakes. We want to protect all kinds of beings. And certain beings are vanishing. Like dinosaurs, they have gone. But whatever the creatures are there, we have to protect. But we want to protect them, but we are not able to sustain them. Why? Because we have understood wrongly certain things. Now, this topic, please bear with me at least 15 minutes. I can clarify you. As I told, every creature, they get completeness. You think about the birds, think about all the trees, think about all the planets and plants. They have their own system of working. We have already seen this topic in the name of Dharma. Dharma means what? That which protects and that which is protected and that which gives punya. Now here, once you are born, you have to work to get completeness. You are not the bird. Bird, there is no choice to go wrong. But human being, you have the choice. You have many choices. If you are not selecting them properly, you may lose your track. Therefore, you have this kartumva, akartumva, anyatava, kartum, shakyam. That's what I call it, free will. You should know how to utilize the free will. Now, free will means what? In simple example, I can make you to understand. If you are standing there, maybe 50 feet far from me, if I call you, now there is a choice. Okay? Somebody is inviting you. You can come to me. That's one decision you can make. Or you can refuse to me. That the next decision, the second one you can make. Then third one, you can come as you wish. You can come jumping. You can come with a singing attitude. And you can also come not directly. You can take a round and you can come like this. This ability you have. You have to go along with the choice, when you select the choice, and you can even reject it, or you can get it done in different way. Now every human, we think that we are victimized by the environment. No, if you are aware, means we are aware about this selecting power which we have, we can utilize properly. Though in engage we were not aware about this, Our parents made all the decisions for us. After a certain age, when we become conscious about our awareness and about our duties, we can learn. That's what all the secrets are kept open to all the human beings. That's what our Sanatana Dharma special is. Because when you study about Shastra, nobody can stop you. Nobody can come and say that you are doing wrong. They will appreciate you. They have to appreciate, because these hidden secrets are kept open, whether you are a male or female or Indian or non-Indian, doesn't matter, or South India, North India, East, West, or doesn't matter. It's meant for you to give the clarity about your own nature, your own duty. Because we have to do something to survive. That survival is the target now. For that survival, we select something. We select certain method to live. Okay? So you can live like an artist. You can live like an engineer. You can live like a doctor. Or you can also have the destination, I want to be a good human being. Then you can serve to the humanity. Being a doctor, you can be a good human being. Being an engineer, you can be. Being a kind of research-oriented person, you can be. So all these together. When you are confused, you cannot select, you cannot utilize your free will. Therefore what Shastra says, there are four categories which are divided by Shastra. Human being can be divided into four categories. Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra. Brahmana is the category and not by birth. By birth, why we are following, that also I will explain. Because by birth, a person can be called a Brahmana. But still, that Brahmana needs to work to be a Brahmana. It's not matter about confusing. It's not matter about isolating a person. No. So this meaning, please, you understand, don't mistake, be with open-minded, okay? Brahmana means a person who wants to reach the goal. For him, money is not a matter, power is not a matter, and luxurious life also he doesn't desire for it, and he even doesn't care about his body. He wants to get healthy mate, therefore what? He directly hits it and he could accept the Almighty. He has that kind of mind to accept Almighty and he wants to seek moksha, he wants to seek dharma. That person can be called a Brahmana. And if that person, if he is provided the knowledge of Vedas, if you provide Veda to him, he will definitely reach his destination soon, like a jet. Okay? So selecting Vedas is an appropriate dharma to a Brahmana. Therefore, Brahmana's dharma is to read Vedas, means study Vedas, practicing Vedas and analyzing the secrets of Vedas. The next category, those people, you know, they are power-oriented people. And what? They also, they don't worry about money. They don't worry about luxurious life. They don't worry about assets. You know, that definition which is given here. They are forceful people. They want to protect dharma. So one of our colleagues, when we were in the ashram studying 3.5 years course under Pujya Swamiji, Dayananda Saraswati. So one brahmachari, he always used to talk about nation. And he always, whenever he speaks about the nation, he becomes very, you know, a rashful attitude person. He used to open a channel, media channel. Now he has opened the media channel, doing well, that's Rajasika, but in order to serve the humanity, to protect dharma, even jaan bhi chale jaye. He doesn't worry about his own life. He wants to just sacrifice his life for dharma. That person is called Kshatriya. Kshatriya has the duty to protect dharma. Duty to protect what? That duty is selected according to your nature. So that duty, it won't disturb. If Brahmana is given a nation power, he cannot be normal. His growth, his self inner growth will be cut, will be destroyed. Therefore what? Outer work, it affects inner growth too. Therefore what? Brahmana should be given knowledge and Kshatriya should be given power, or Kshatriya should be given responsibility to take care of dharma. And one more nature, the next nature is expansions. Whatever you give, he wants to expand it. But he is Alankar Priyaha. He desires for money. He desires for even, you know, name and fame. He wants to see different land, different persons. He wants to have a transaction with the people. He wants to learn about agricultures and business. All business mind. He just knows how to multiply. And the enjoyment called Vaishya. Nothing wrong in it, because economic is dependent on him. This economy, what we called it, you know, the growth of nation, it depends on these people. These people means that kind of category of people. So you cannot give power to him. That inner growth will be destroyed, stopped, and you cannot give even knowledge of Vedas. No. He should be given business. That becomes his Swadharma. And the next person is a wonderful person who gives food to the humanity. For him, he doesn't care about Ishvara. He doesn't care about Dharma. And he doesn't care about economic status of the nation, but he wants to provide food for all. He wants to serve to the humanity. For him, all the beings are nothing but Ishvara. That is the attitude, and with clarity. He doesn't want to work means he doesn't want to work intellectually. He is physically fit, he can work and produce food. Annadatha. These are the categories are divided by our Shastra. Now there is no difference among these four categories. Now you can realize, so what the nature I have, whether I am having Brahmana nature or Kshatriya nature or Vaishyas or Shudras. In order to give self clarity about the self, these words are not too confused. To give clarity, what kind of duty that I could say, like duty means, which is in the form of karma. But you have the duty, a father has the duty to bring his child up. And child means the son of a father, he has the duty to take care of his father later on. Those duties also must be valued by this Kshatriya Brahmana Vaishya Shudra. There's a social aspects. When you select according to your nature, inner growth and outer growth, both together, you can get completeness. For that purpose alone, Shastra talks about this Brahmana Kshatriya Vaishya Shudra Varna Dharma. Bhagavan Krishna himself, he says very clearly, Chatur Varnyam Maya Srishtam Guna karma vibhagasaha tasya kartaram api mam vidya kartaram avyayam. This varna dharma is created by me. Created by me is not to confuse the society, to give more clarity. Your inner growth is the real growth, man. Shastra supports you. If you have the nature of Kshatriya, go and get the field where you can work. You can go to media, you can go for politics, you can go for army in order to be part of the social issues At the same time, your nature is, you know, it's suitable to that field. You can also get growth inside. You can sleep well. If you wrongly select, means if you use your free will wrongly to select, a Brahmana nature person should not select this power oriented field. This Kshatriya person should not select business oriented or this knowledge oriented field. Then what? This inner growth will be stopped, then restlessness. Therefore, chaos. After studying 15 years of studies, people are confused because they are not aware about these things. Now, Arjuna, you have studied about the duty of Kshatriya. Being Kshatriya, it is your duty to protect people, nothing wrong in it. And you know, a Kshatriya should be very happy when he gets a chance to fight, to sacrifice his life for Dharma. You become a, you know, you should become a very happy person to fight for Dharma. It's a chance. A king means sitting and enjoying all the enjoyments is not a king. A king who should not have his own assets. Brahmanas and Kshatriyas, they need not to have assets, because so this king provides many assets to the Brahmana, like Yajnavalkya. They will use only for the nations, human being or all other being too. Kshatriya too, he won't have his own assets. Brahmana lives with Bhiksha, his life. King also lives with the people's money. Therefore what? He becomes more responsible person. He should be more responsible person in order to give them back. And Vaishya, he earns money, but he is a very important person to maintain economy, means economic level of the nation. Shudra, everybody, they have their contribution. That's what Pujya Swami Dayananda Saraswati used to say. See, life, successful life is to become a contributor, means consumer to a contributor. Contributor means what? So when you do something, you should get complete growth. At the same time, this entire universe also should be benefited what you do about. That's the life. That's the proper life. That life alone here mentioned by Lord Krishna. Arjuna, you said you are talking like a Brahmana. You are not a Brahmana. Your nature is not Brahmana. If you select that way, definitely you will be in pain, in chaos, in future, not only to you. You will be problematic person, the people around you. Dukkham aktum ayogataha. Bhagavan Krishna himself says, if you select a field, if you select a duty which is not suitable to your nature, which is not going to give any growth to you, by that, so that you will become in chaos and you will also problematic for others, means the people belong to you. Therefore, Arjuna, be careful. This is a great choice. Now you are deluded. Don't you see that you got an opportunity to protect Dharma? Are you covered, fighting for your life? No, that's not you. You are a little bit confused. Okay, just go ahead. That's what he gives a strong dosage after giving the knowledge of Atma. Okay, we will continue tomorrow in the next episode. Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Om Namo Narayana.